Today, it's about music a little too dramatic, you think? Yeah. Well, today it's about this, you guys. A sneaky important amino acid that flies way under the radar. It's called ergothionine. I bet you've never even heard of it. Ergo for short. Right up front, I'm going to recommend you add it to your diet. Let's see why. Oh, I know. And I usually set my vids in settings like mountains, streams, the woods, you know, calm stuff like that. Today I thought it would be nice to spend a ridiculous amount of money and rent a really cool, swanky, expensive downtown loft. You know, a little change of pace. Okay, amino acids then. What about them? Well, they're organic molecules that have been around for a few billion years. They're recognized as, and let's not put too much pressure on them, but the building blocks of life. What does that mean? Well, no amino acids, no human species. Aminos play critical roles in countless physiological functions. All proteins are composed of amino acids. Enzymes, immune system modulators, they act as hormones, on and on. So really quick, amino acids are countless in nature. Over 500 have been identified to date, yet only 20 are identified in the standard genetic code. Think about that. Our bodies can synthesize about half of those. The remaining 9 need to be derived from the diet. These are known as the essential amino acids. No way around it. Deficiency of even one amino acid will result in less than healthy cellular function, and chronic amino acid deficiency will lead to chronic unwellness. Okay, ergothionine now. Really cool story. I'm a little geeky about physiology and biochem. I'm going to leave some links in the description for those of you who are too. But let's give you the nuts and bolts right now. Ergo was discovered in 1909 in the course of some other research, largely ignored for years as, you know, just another amino acid among hundreds. But then a funny thing happened. In 2005, over a century later, German researchers discovered, while in the course of research on Crohn's disease and rheumatoid arthritis, a unique special chemical transporter in human cells. Guess what it was transporting? Yep, ergothionine. Specifically ergothionine. Nothing else. Its sole purpose was to usher this otherwise forgotten amino acid into certain cells. Wow, that's huge, right? Why? Well, you see, the body does not keep systems around, chemical pathways and so forth, for no good reason. It's biologically inefficient, and the body, if nothing else, wants to be efficient. Therefore, what? Ergo must play an important physiological role. So what are we onto here then? Well, interestingly, these ergo transport mechanisms are situated and concentrated in tissues that are highly susceptible to oxidative and inflammatory damage. Bone marrow, blood cells, liver, eyes, even the mitochondria of cells housing DNA. Ergo would seem to be crucial as a protector of some of our most important tissues then, wouldn't it? Well, yes, as it turns out, it's pretty amazing stuff. Ergo has undergone an awful lot of research of late, as you can well imagine. And here's some of what I found in the published literature. Ergothionine penetrates the mitochondria of the cell, protecting them and DNA from the inside out. Certain edible mushrooms are by far the highest dietary source of ergothionine, 40 times higher than the next best source. Ergo is an extremely potent anti-inflammatory and antioxidant. What should I say? Should I say that? Blurb on it? Everyone seems to be hyper-concerned about COVID and its variants at this point. Let me take you to an interesting study I read in the National Library of Medicine. Ergothionine has exhibited the ability to modulate inflammation, scavenge free radicals, protect against acute respiratory distress syndrome, prevent endothelial dysfunction, protect against neuronal damage, nerve damage, hinder lung and liver fibrosis problems, mitigate damage to the lungs, kidneys, liver, GI tract, and testis, among others. This evidence suggests that ergothionine has a potential application, here we go, in the treatment of the underlying pathology of COVID-19. Let me read that last line again. Potential application in the treatment of the underlying pathology of COVID-19. Next case. The demonstrated cytoprotective or cell protective effect of ergothionine has led many to suggest a potential therapeutic role for this compound in chronic conditions that involve ongoing oxidative stress, including cardiovascular and metabolic diseases. Next. Have you heard of endothelium? It's the layer of cells lining blood vessels, lymphatic vessels, heart tissue, and so forth. Ergothionine is taken up by the endothelial cells, where the compound then protects against oxidative stress, curtailing endothelial dysfunction. Very key in heart disease and those kinds of issues, chronic underlying inflammatory problems. Next. This study demonstrated that certain mushroom species are high in glutathione, a huge antioxidant, and ergothionine, and should be considered an excellent dietary source of these important antioxidants. Next study. Ever heard of telomeres? Just know that they're important in protecting your DNA from damage. Damaged DNA leads to early degenerative disease and early aging. Ergothionine demonstrated beneficial effects by decreasing the rate of telomere shortening and preserving telomere length under oxidative stress. Our data supports potential role of ergo in oxidative stress-related conditions and healthy aging. Next study, and I'll wrap it up with this, but we could go on. There's mounting evidence for the potential for the natural dietary antioxidant ergothionine, ergo, to prevent or mitigate chronic diseases of aging. This has led to the suggestion that it could be considered a longevity vitamin. Ergo is produced in nature only by certain fungi and a few other microbes. Mushrooms are by far the leading dietary source of ergo. So I get it. I think I bang the same drum over and over in my vids. Vibrant health doesn't come in a bottle. It doesn't come in a pill. Mother Nature sets the ground rules. They're pretty simple, but not all that easy to follow sometimes, are they, right? But you guys know by now that I love functional medicinal mushrooms. I love the broad range of benefits, the nutritional profile, the amino acid analysis, and so forth. Turkey tail, reishi, cordyceps, lion's mane, on and on we go, right? Patients ask me why I like to eat a range of these things. Well, there's an overlapping baseline of sort of similar properties, anti-inflammatory, antioxidant, sort of across the whole range. But each has a specific quality that is unique to it. So we're talking about ergothionine amino acid here. So in this case, shiitake and oyster mushrooms providing by far the highest concentrations of ergothionine of any food source on the planet are the two ingredients of this product from Real Mushrooms, Ergo Plus. So that's the story. Ergothionine, largely ignored for over a century, turns out recently to be one of the powerful antioxidant, anti-inflammatory, anti-aging amino acids available. It's something that you might want to think about putting into your diet. I certainly have. Please check the links below to all the papers I referenced, to the Real Mushrooms site. And please, if you enjoyed the video, give me a thumbs up. And until we see you again, yet again, yours in vibrant health, Dr. J.